Search is a big part of Android TV. Let's see it in action. Cat videos. Neat, right? You can use search to expose content from your app so users can get to it straight from the home screen.
Here's how search works. Android TV shows search results from Google as well as locally installed searchable apps. To make our app searchable, we implement a content provider to provide search results for a query. Android TV combines these results into a search results page. Users now have one-click access to launch content you return using a pending intent you provide. For this to work, we'll have to map our data into a cursor format that's expected by the system. If you've previously worked with search on Android, for example on a mobile device, then you should know that Android TV uses exactly the same search interface that you might have already built for another form factor. In this section, I'll describe the key steps involved, and you can check out the instructor notes for more detail. Before we go any further, we should talk about privacy. Protecting user privacy is key, and many users consider their activities on TV, including searches, to be private information. Here are two tips. Never send personal information over the network. For example, if a user is searching for a pizza restaurant near them, you don't need to send their user ID to the server along with their zip code. Now, in the rare case that you have to send personal info, you should never log it. And if for some reason you do have to log it, then you should protect that data extremely carefully and erase it as soon as possible. Also, be sure to provide users with an easy way to clear their search history. The first step is to define an activity to respond to the search request. Here we are inside our manifest. The first step will be to define an activity that will be launched when the user selects one of our results from the TV home screen. We declare this activity to accept the action search intent using this intent filter. We also have to specify the search configuration to use using this metadata element and this XML. You can find this data inside of searchable.xml and see the instructor notes for a description of the fields. Now, when our movie details activity is launched, we need to resolve the search data and display the corresponding movie. You can see how we do that inside the check global search intent method. Here we check to see if the intent action corresponds to global search, and if so, we pull the selected movie ID out of the intent. Next, we need to define a content provider which returns search results to the Android TV search dialog. We only need to implement a part of it, and all the necessary columns are already defined by the SDK. And you can find a step-by-step guide for building a content provider in the instructor notes or the Android Fundamentals course. First, let's define a content provider in the manifest. Here we'll use the video content provider. Also make sure that exported is set to true so Android TV Global Search can use the results. You should see the instructor notes for more info about securing your content provider. Here we are inside our video content provider, and the first step is to implement the query method. Now usually this takes 5 arguments. Our provider though only needs to provide search results, and the only argument we need to handle is selection args. This contains the search terms from the user. Because of the way we configured our searchable.xml, it will only contain a single element, which represents the entire search string. The last thing we need to do to finish our search provider is to pack the search results into the cursor format that's expected by Android TV. The data fields expected are represented as columns of a SQLite database. And regardless of your data's original format, you must map your data fields to these columns. You can find a description of all of these in the instructor notes. To polish your search results, you can also add a watch action link. As you can see here, this search result actually came from Google, but when a user clicks this button, it will launch your app. In order for this to work, these 3 fields returned by your search data must match those from Google. When these 3 fields match, Android TV will automatically attach the Watch Action link to the search result card. So it's in your favor to provide accurate metadata with your search results. There's one last thing you can do to polish your app, and here's in-app search. Notice that here we've added the search button to the browse fragment. At this point, we've already got our content provider working, and all we have to do is add a fragment provided by the Leanback support library. That fragment is the search fragment, and you can see details on how to use it in the instructor notes. The pattern is exactly the same as we've seen previously in this course.